part, which is the tradition up in the first part, because slavery is a consequence of systemic racism. In Virginia, we see black slaves and nothing else. We don't see Arab slaves. So they're slaves because they're black. So it's a consequence of systemic racism that's going on. So what is systemic racism? Systemic racism is basically something that has been done as a way of governance. From the independence in 1960 to this day, the government has set up their politics in a way to discriminate one composition of the country, which is the blacks. The blacks are divided in two big categories. There is the Haritans, which are the slaves, and there is a second part, which are, we call them the African Mauritanians. The Haritans are slaves, but culturally, they are Arabs. The slaves speak the language of their masters. The other compositions of the population are the Fulanis, who speak Fulani, the Soninkes, who speak Soninke, the Wolofs, and then the Bambaras. They're not technically slaves, but at the same time, they are not put at the same level as the Arabs. So from the independence of this day, the government has been putting policies in place to be able to keep not only the slaves down, but the other part of the populations who are the Fulanis I was just talking about and the rest of the population down. How has it been operated? It has been operated in a few ways. The first way is wealth. The people who are governing have most of the wealth of the country, and the rest of the populations who are the blacks in general, including the slaves, don't have as much opportunities to get wealth or to be working in the government as much as the other populations are doing it, because they're putting the policies in place to make the white ones, the Arabs, a favorite and giving them more opportunities that are not available to the rest of the population. So the ground is not fair from the beginning for them to have different equal chances. And the other part, the other way they're doing it is through the education system. Again, as I said, the Haritans are culturally, the slaves are culturally Arab because they learn the language of their masters. But the rest of the black people in Mauritania are not Arabs. They're not culturally Arabs. They're Fulanis, they're Soninkes, they're Wolof, they're Bambaras. But when you go into the Mauritanian systemic education, in the education system, they are putting people have to study the Arab language. So when you come into the system of the education system in Mauritania, Arabic is your first language, and you're a Fulani, you are not competing at the equal level from the beginning, because when you come into the education system in Mauritania, you have to start with Arabic. That's one. Two, when as you grow on the ranks in classes, the way the Arabic is set up is in a way you have to have good grades in Arabic to be able to succeed. So these people are already coming in, that's their language. We have to compete with them with Arabics. By we, I mean the Fulanis, the Wolof, and the rest of them. We have to compete with them with the Arabic, which is their first language. Then we have to compete in a different foreign language, which is French, at some point. So we competed in two different languages that are not ours, and they already have the Arabic as an advantage. So the system, the education system is set up in a way that is giving them a favor to be able to succeed better in the education system. At the same time, we don't get a chance to learn our languages. They're saying, okay, we will teach you guys French. We would love to learn a foreign language, but what about our languages? We want our culture to be at the same level as Arabic culture, but we're not given a chance, not even a chance to study our own mother languages, which are the Fulanis, the Wolofs, and the Soninkes. That's just the way the government is set up, which is systemic racism I was talking about, and also the education system of Mauritania is not set up in a way to give people equal chances. In addition to that, the government has put together, from the independence to this day, policies in a way that discriminates the people. And most of the black people who are the Fulanis, the Soninkes, and the Wolofs have seen that. And in 1986, the intellectuals of the black Mauritania have put it together. They sat together, because the way they see in the government, if we have 22 government officials in the administration, about 7 of them are composed of Fulanis, Soninkes, Wolofs, and Bambaras, and Haritans. So all the black people in Mauritania, who are about 70%, they share 7 government officials out of 22. Everybody else is Arabs. or the white most, what we call them. So in 1986, the way the government was set up, from the education system to the way of governance to the way the government is giving the Arabic population a way to acquire wealth that was not given to the rest of them, the black intellectuals sat down and said, something is not right here. Because if we continue to do this, they are going to advance way more than us, and we feel like the playing level is not equal. And we have to basically bring this up so as a nation we can have a conversation, because this is not right. That's when the black Mauritanians wrote a book called The Manifesto of the Oppressed Black Mauritanian, in which with numbers and statistics, they showed that there's no equality in Mauritania. And at the time it was 1986, and the government at the time, the president at the time was called Mawia, and he went out of the country. He went to like some kind of a conference, and he was talking to the president of Burkina Faso at the time, Thomas Sankara, about apartheid in South Africa. And Thomas Sankara was like, you got nothing to say. There is worse than apartheid in your country. And he was like, how do you know this? And he pulled a copy of the book, and he said, this is it. And this was written by people in your own country. And he came, the president at the time, Mawia, was Mawia, and he came back, he was furious. He took all of the people who wrote